Welcome at Christiani.biz and appreciate your visit. I have a little something I would like to share with you and hopefully saves you some precious time. It was for creating some stands and I needed something flexible for last minute changes, and as you know there are always last changes and the very last minute. So I came up with that little rig that's helped me and hopefully will help you in the future if you come into two situations to populate the scene with a stand. Well, nothing sophisticated, you see, it's meant more to seen a bit from a distance and not to be zoomed in too closely, but looks okay, and you have some settings you can change the look to your likings, and hopefully you find and can create easily the stance you were looking for, your scene, the way you would like to see them. Well, enough bubbling, let's get to it. Overall scale, yeah, well, guess what it does? It scales up, it scales down, and I have to admit on the upper side of scaling up it's a bit limited, but don't worry, on those flashes you can pull it up and scale it to incredible dimensions. But let's keep it around 50%. That was the scale around the range I had to work in. And let's get the next setting, stands. Well, we want to have a large stand, do we? Or we want to have a small stand? We decide. Anyway, that is the setting here, and to change the look you can go even further and change the size of the standing or sitting portions on the stands. And like in large stadiums, of course, there are wider and smaller stadiums, these areas are narrow. Roof height, you wonder what is roof height? There is no roof. In the display you find a little button where you can turn on your roofs and also change the look of it by just a simple slider. Put them up, put them down, help sometimes just to adjust a little bit what you're looking for. Color, yes, in Europe we write color that way, don't worry. But you can change colors for individual elements, and you see here I'm just using two colors and the railings with a kind of a fake metallic look, also to keep render time as low. And as I said, we look at it from a certain distance, so that's okay. What I would recommend you is to turn on the chairs the second, or if you want chairs, but turn it on the very last moment when you have everything set up and now you're ready to render. Don't forget, click on that button and you get chairs, and you see immediately why. The second you want, when you want to manipulate the scene, it gets slow because there's a lot of geometry to calculate. So I repeat, turn it on, but don't forget it in the very last second when you're ready for render. And well, that's it. Have fun with it, and hopefully it saves you some precious time and gets you a nice scene with a stand in the background. And I would love to see a render when you use it, and I would be willing to share it on the site. Okay, anyway, have fun with it and talk to you soon. Bye bye.